Hello everyone and welcome to the Stream TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you look into the gap welding technique on 12 inch elbow sked 80 elbow to flange. It's gonna be in a position for the root pass for video purposes. I'm just gonna show you my view. There is what is the advantage look into the gap technique, especially if you're in a position. It's as we know, in position in the field, there's a lot of spots. You don't want to break your spine and hurt yourself. So it's good to know technique. Look into the gaps. You don't have to really bend over, especially doing overhead. You can go from the top of the pipe and start doing your route on a pipe. Pretty much as always, make sure the pipe is really good prepared, nice and clean. Go inch and a half, 2 inches from the edge. Make sure this is all new stuff, new spool, so shouldn't be any contamination inside or any residue inside, so but you never know. So looking through the gap, as I said, lots of advantages, good skill to have. Make sure your gap is consistent pretty much as possible, especially in the field. Doesn't have to be perfect, and it's not perfect even with the new fit up here. I'm gonna show you there's a little bit high low, couple mil, which is ideally for this kind of technique. Is pretty much going 3 mil above the edge of your root, and this is how you feed. You keep that rod constantly in a weld puddle. So for this, it's gonna be freehand 1/8 tungsten. Cup size 8. It doesn't have to be 8, you can use any cup you feel comfortable with. I go with 8 as it's new, and as I said, pretty much freehand holding side to side motion. Try to keep the rod constantly in the puddle. The good thing about looking through the gap, as I said, you got a nice clear view of your weld puddle and what's going on inside. One thing, as mentioned, for the gap, try to have at least loose 1/8, 5/32, so you can freely hold and manipulate that filler wire inside that gap, so it's not going to shrink, it's not going to bite for that rod, and it's going to stuck. You don't want to do that, and this is the view. So once you start at start point, connect edges and try to hold on the top of the weld puddle. As I'm looking from the top through the gap and just holding that filler wire on the top of my puddle and slightly manipulating with my torch, side to side motion. And this is how you form nice, good, solid root inside. Even if you have a little bit, as I said, a high low inside, it's not a big deal. It's not a problem. This is actually perfect. It's perfect when you combine all that experience you got and skill. It's gonna save your body. That's for sure. You don't have to go if it's, as I said, position weld, and we all know how many ugly position welds we had. And this is a definite life changer technique, life changer skill. Your body's gonna be grateful to you one day, especially when you get older. You don't have to break your spine bones. Just position yourself on the top. Make sure you have there's no any obstacles. You have a nice, good gap. And just feed that rod through the gap. And the good thing about freehand and looking through the gap, you can really put really nice, good looking root. You know, it's solid because, as I said, you keep it on the top of your puddle, and this is how you got the perfect build up for your root, especially on the bottom part. Even if your bottom is shrink a little bit and you don't want to struggle too much with overhead, that's why looking through the gap from the top, you can always feed the rod, keeping it inside. You got nice clear view. of your amount of your root thickness of your buildup. There's a lots of benefit to it. As I said, you can control way better control. This is pretty much once you get up to 8-9 o'clock, then you can lean on a nozzle in your inside a bevel, and you can walk the cup on your root, or you can freehand all the way up. It doesn't really matter, whatever it's easier for you. But I'm just looking for any shortcut that I don't have to, you know, don't go turn to fatigue mod. Especially when you get certain ages, you know, start getting shaky, and that's why you want to control your feed hand and your torch to minimize any shakiness if you have, or just want to have a nice steady arm, nice both hands. And that's it pretty much for this side. I'm just gonna finish up that top a little bit. That's it. There's a lots of, as I said, benefit to it. The root looks good, it looks consistent all the way from that nice good looking ring. Now we're gonna do it from the other side. That's how you see it from the top. I'm just gonna connect here. You can grind stop starts if you'd like. It all depends. It all depends from the equipment you're using, from the torch, from the material you're welding. If you're welding on any kind of chrome, or definitely want a stop start. This is technique you can pretty much use only on carbon, mostly on carbon. You can use on stainless as well, as I said, not really on a small stuff, small pipe, but on a bigger pipe, thicker, yes, definitely. You can always have a window on the top, open that window, and you can pretty much do the same thing on the stainless stuff. But with stainless, there's also other risk involved, is you gotta open a little bit bigger section of the pipe, and all your purge is gonna go out. And there's always pros and cons. As I said, for carbon, definitely works well. Good skill, good technique to have. It's pretty much simple. You just gotta catch up, coordinate both hands and your vision. As I said, no any obstacles in the inside. Position your body really well, so you got a nice good view. The good thing as well, you can always change or adjust your body positioning with that. I got a little pinhole that's just normal. It's from the torch I'm using. I'm just doing a hard pull when I stop. I'm just gonna grind that out a little bit, and from now on, as I said, from 3 or 9 o'clock, I always lean my nozzle inside that bevel and just walk the cup all the way to the top. Pretty much the same thing. So if you want to keep consistent the thickness of that root, the same buildup, just gonna hold inside that rod, that filler wire, hold inside, same thing. It all depends from the gap. If you got nice good, like in my case, it was 1/8 gap, and just hold the rod inside, hold on the top of that puddle, and just speed up with your travel speed. You don't want to pause too much. Just have nice consistent steps with stretching that puddle, and you should have nice good and consistent root pretty much all the way around. And that's it. This is the root. The root looks good, looks solid all the way around. There's just two spots for tie-ins that didn't properly tie in to be really perfect, but it doesn't really matter, it's good. And that's it for the looking through the gap. Now from now on, well-known game, hot pass. I'm using a cup size 12 and 180 amps for the hot pass. You know, when you got good solid root, you don't have to be worried about a sack back, as that's always one of the major concerns, you know. But that's one of the reasons why you want to have good solid root. Then there's no place to any worry about sack back on your root pass. And that's it pretty much for today's video, guys. Hope you like it. Hope you enjoy it. This video, as I said, I did in a position to make you, to help you out, guys. If you didn't try yet, try it out. Good skill to have. And if you like this video, thumbs, like, share, and see you in the next one. Take care.